Restarting. Okay, so redo. If you have any questions throughout this time together, please use the chat and send me a message, and I will circle back at the end and try to answer those questions. And if either we run out of time or it's something that requires more discussion, Jen's going to send you an email after with some information, and there'll be a link there if you want to book in for a phone call when it best suits you, and you'll just have access to a calendar to call. So a few things we want to go over today. First is want to give you guys an update on all the things at the gym that are to do with air quality. It's something that most people are interested in these days, and we just wanted to give you guys the full update because some of the things people aren't aware of. Then want to go into membership upgrades and talk about what we were doing before and what we're going to be moving towards in the future, as well as talk a little bit about the program that some people are on already if they're choosing to be at home, whether for COVID reasons or personal reasons, or if they're just too far away to get to the gym. And if you want an in-depth look at that, we do have a recording from a webinar we did today at lunch just specifically on that program. So let's get right into it. In terms of the air, obviously it's very important to have good air. Aside from having masks and being appropriately spaced due to the regulations, which we of course are doing, we have two units, one in each training room, HRV units, and they're on and they're continuously bringing in cold, fresh air and cycling out the used air all the time that you're in the training room. So that is the law, but it's not to say that that's always the case. So we have filters in there that we change. And so there's always air flowing in there. Some of you might have been stuck underneath one of the pipes once and got a cool breeze in the winter. And so that's what that is. We didn't have the fans on this summer. If anyone, show of hands, you were in there this summer. Of course, when we were allowed to reopen, was two of the hottest weeks known to man. So you probably remember those times, but we weren't advised to turn on big fans to blow air all over the place. And so we just decided we would abide by those recommendations. And that's another reason we haven't reintroduced the big fan bikes into the training at the gym. The newest addition is we had both our furnaces had to be replaced last week. What are the chances? But so we got upgraded furnaces, and tomorrow in the furnace that goes into the training rooms, we're putting an air purifying system. And I'll send a video out in the future for anyone who's interested, but it sends out ions into the room, and those will clump with dust and allergens and pathogens and remove those so we can have even better air than we've had. So those are just a few little updates on the air quality. In terms of the training in general in the gym, many of you are probably familiar, if you've been in, that we haven't been able to train with more than 10 people. And oftentimes there'll be groups of 3, 4, 7, 8, depending on the time. So we're forced to do that, but we feel that to actually have anything to have stability moving into the future, we're going to continue moving with that, not just because we are forced to do that, but even we know when and if eventually regulations are changed, a lot of people aren't going to feel comfortable just running back into high-fiving everybody and having 20 people running around the room. I think there's going to be a lot of changes. And so we are permanently going to move to what's called a small group training model, which is what we've been doing since we opened in June. In the fitness world, there's kind of four types of training. There is a large group training, which is up to 30 sometimes, and we had a cap of 20, so we were kind of in that category. Small group training is 4 to 10, which is where we are now and will be in the future. And then there's something called semi-private training, which is 2 to 4, and personal training you've probably heard of. So at the beginning, we were kind of like, what are we going to do? But we're deciding that to move forward and to actually feel confident that things aren't going to be switched around on us all the time, we're just going to embrace the small group training model. And some of the things that would be hopefully interesting or valuable to you folks is that just by numbers alone, you'll be able to get more attention in the room, whether it be for safety corrections or for challenging you in a different way, or for just some encouragement. Before, when we had the 20 group size, we often would have 3, 4, 5 different stations going on at the same time. And now the training room runs that we are doing one exercise at a time. So for a coaching perspective, it's a lot easier to stay focused when you have less people and only one exercise at a time. And with some of the innovations in our program that we've done this year, some of you might be familiar with our I go, you go format. We're actually able to have only one side of the room training and the other side resting. So the coach can really focus just on half of who's ever in there. So we're going to continue to develop that. And we see the upside of that being paying a lot more attention and moving people towards their goals or whatever they're interested in a lot quicker than we were able to do before. In terms of the amount of workouts per week, we have been doing 6 different training sessions per week since March. The previous, 10 years, we had basically stuck with the 3 different training sessions a week. Initially, we did this because people were online and we wanted people to be able to get in some movement every day without feeling that they would have to do the same thing, twice in a row. And that worked really well. And then the feedback we got was that people really liked the variety and being able to pick which ones they liked and that kind of thing. So we're going to continue on with that and just keep that 6 different training sessions a week. So that if you were to need to come 2 days in a row, you wouldn't have to worry about overdoing it by doing the same workout. Before, obviously, we shared all our equipment with everybody and I didn't really think much about it. Of course, now in the gym, everybody has their own stuff. They have their own space with their own strength equipment and their own TRX and med balls or ropes or whatever. And we're going to keep along that theme and continue to figure out how we can add and develop that experience for you. We've heard that some places, they say in a training round, they work for 30 seconds, quickly try to clean it, and then pass it off to someone else coming. We think that's like way too stressful for us. And the way that we clean and spray the equipment, it takes at the end of class 10 or 12 minutes to dry and to do its job anyways. So we're going to continue to just keep it. Everybody just uses what they're using for the whole time. And so we don't have to worry about sharing it all. So a few changes with that. Has anybody here had the privilege of seeing or meeting Kaylee or being trained by Kaylee in person or online? So Kaylee is our newest hire, and we hired her basically as an insurance type of policy, because right now, as you know, I'm sure some of you guys have had crazy stuff happen to you almost every day. We felt that if, say, for example, my son Jack, he had a cold 2 weeks ago. Everybody gets tested. I can't go to work. I can't coach. We know this is our reality now. It's already happened to 2 of us. So having that extra hire just to fill in when things come up that are unpredictable will give us a way better chance of continuing to do all the coaching sessions for you guys. So that was the reason for that. In terms of the amount of coach sessions we have per week, right now we're doing 55 coach sessions a week. Just to give a reference point, in February we were doing 30. So almost double, and we've added some different times on different days and tried to give a lot of options for that. And we're going to continue to do that moving forward. If you had signed up for this webinar before an hour ago, you would have received some membership paperwork. So if you didn't check your email, there's some updated membership paperwork that will take in effect starting in November. So I want to go over some of the things with you. Whenever it talks about the word basic, that's the 2 times a week in the gym. standard 3 times a week, and premium is 4 times a week. So we have a 4 times a week option. The thing that is going to be probably one thing that stands out is before, when we did 2 times a week memberships, if you missed a session, you had to make it up within that week. But we just feel with all the different craziness going on, that's not very realistic for anybody to do, especially if you're staying home for cautionary reasons, or someone's getting tested in your family. So we've actually increased that from the same week to making it up within 2 months. So within 8 weeks instead of the same week. So that way, hopefully you feel less stress about getting in your session right away, and you can have up to 2 months to make up that missed session. For the standard or 3 times a week people, you're going to have 12 weeks or 3 months to make up a missed session. And for the premium or 4 times a week, you'll have 4 months or 16 weeks to make up that session. We don't want people to feel pressured to come in if they're not feeling well. And even if you are feeling okay, but you think you should stay home that day, we'd rather you use the virtual or the recorded workouts, and just to help keep everybody as safe as possible. So with that, we'll definitely need to do a little bit of education on how on your MindBody app you can tell how many sessions you have and when they expire. But the gist of it is that you have a really long time. And so hopefully that alleviates some pressure for those of you who have to miss a day or things like that. And now that we have 6 different workouts a week, you know, you can do a Monday, Tuesday, or a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and it'll all work out nicely in terms of balancing out the body, how the programs are designed these days. In terms of other things that we haven't done in a while that we'd like to get back to, most of you haven't gotten a movement screen in a long time. And we thought initially the main focus was, let's just get everybody moving. We know how you guys move. Our coaches pay attention. We have notes, and there's a lot of touching and people coming in and out a lot. So in the last couple months, we actually redesigned the movement screen to make it more specific to what we're doing. So it's a little bit quicker to do. There's less touching, and we actually added a strength component. For example, if you don't have any pain and everything's looking pretty good, we might throw in something like a Turkish getup and watch your rep, and then be able to give you some very specific tips on how to make progressions to improve your strength. And of course, if that's not the exercise that's best for you, we could do another baseline. So we add a little bit of a strength factor into that. And everybody will have access to that 2 times a year. And the other thing is if you don't want to wait like 6 months to get something retested, that say your shoulder is getting better and you want to say overhead press and you don't want to have to wait 6 months, if you're working on that, you can come early to class and ask your coach to what we call spot check you, and they can just do that part of the screen right there. And if you're clear, you're clear, so that you can do that at any time and not have to wait so long. So that's how the movement screens will go. And we will try to start working those in as soon as November as well. In terms of the workshops that we offered, we're going to start to begin to work those back in. And there's, you guys probably remember the deadlift, the swing, some of those ones we included in membership. You're going to be able to come to those as many times as you want. When we offer them, there's not going to be a limit on those. Some people are rusty, and other people, it might just work with their schedule to come in and get some movement and to move the weights around a bit. So we're going to try to bring those back this year as well. In terms of the online workouts, we're going to continue to add 6 to 8 recorded sessions a phase. So right now, I actually bumped off Jen and Brennan, who were trying to record a session that's coming out next week. So we're doing all our recording this week, and then we'll have those workouts ready for you, especially if you want to track along with what we're doing exactly at the gym and you're not there, then you can do that in real time. So we're going to continue that as well as the live workouts. And that's going to come in very handy for those people who are only working out at home and not able to come in. The last two sections on here, one says reserve sessions. So a long time ago, earlier in the year, everybody had their home time slots that usually worked for them. But we've kind of given the flexibility for everybody just to sign in and sign out to whatever session works for them in that day. And that's been working really well. So we don't have those reserve sessions anymore. If someone's a 4-time-a-week member, then that just means that the office is just going to pre-book their sessions for them. And then the open gym category below, that just means that we have open gym time when we're open, but we're not doing coach sessions. So people who are signed up for that 4 times a week, they can also come and do a stretch routine or do a workout on their own time during daytime hours or when we have staff there, and they can do that on their own. So that's just what open gym means. Kind of like if any of you folks, the last time we did a 30-day challenge, you could come in our open times and just work out, that same idea. So that's a quick rundown of that. There's also a specific paperwork. If you want it, you can send the office a request for it. It's simply for our online accountability program, and this is called Resilient. So it's called our Resilient Health and Fitness Accountability Program. And so if people, again, aren't comfortable coming in, or they live far away, or in the event that we get totally shut down again, this will be the program that we'll transition people to. And the way it's different than it was before is you'll have a coach that checks in every week with you to make sure you're on track, or that if there's any adjustments you'd like to make to your program, that you can do that without falling off the wagon or months going by. Every 5 weeks, you'll set up a monthly success plan. And that might simply mean, coach, I want to work out Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I'd like to do it at this time. And that would be what the coach would check in on, or you'd report on once a week, so that you can have that communication and we know what's going on. So the people who come into the gym, we see you, we know if you're not there, if you're supposed to be there, but the people who are at home only doing online, we really have no idea if what's going on sometimes. So that personal accountability is gonna be huge, and often the difference between people doing nothing and people being fairly consistent. They're gonna get access, of course, to all of our recorded content and our virtual content. But if people are sick of doing online workouts, then we'll support them and hold them accountable to whatever they feel is a part of their healthy lifestyle. So that could be nutrition or going for walks or anything. The main thing is that you have that accountability and support, and that you feel like you can have some success through this time that we don't know when it's going to end. There's also an accountability group option on there, which is kind of in progress, where on the app, there'll be a community section where people can message and say to each other that I'm going to do this workout, and kind of hold some accountability that way. So there's a lot of neat stuff coming with that. Awesome. Appreciate you guys listening, hanging tight with me here. So what's to do next? So you're going to have the membership paperwork. You're going to get an email after. There are some price increases, so you're going to want to look at that. There's two options. One, if you know you want to continue and you want to be 12 months is your usual commitment. If people are willing to restart in November, whenever your normal payment would come out, restart a new 12-month commitment, then we're going to allow people to have 3 more months, so until February, at the current pricing that you're already receiving. If you want to keep on the membership that you're having now and you don't want to do that, then the new pricing will kick in on whatever day your payment usually comes out. So you all have an individual date. So if it's the 18th, on November 18th, the new payment would kick in to play, unless you wanted to renew right away for 12 more months. You would receive those first 3 months at current pricing. So you'll get an email this evening, and you don't have to reply to it right away unless you know what you want to do. But we're just asking people to get back to us by October 23rd. So it's not this Friday, but the next Friday, so that we can be prepared and get you set up for whatever we're doing next. So that's basically most of the details that I got for you today. And one question that was asked is if there's a limit to how many times people can go to the online workouts. And no, you can do that every day if you'd like. So I'll just get that question out of the way. And I'll leave a few minutes here for you folks. If you have questions, you know, you want answered, just to throw them in the chat, and then I'll address those. And if you don't have any questions, then I hope you have a great, great rest of your evening, and we see you online or in the gym tomorrow for our mobility sessions. And if you do want a further conversation or phone call, there'll be a link right in the email that goes directly to our phone calendar, and we can find a time to chat with you folks. So really appreciate you guys being here. You've probably had a long day of work and some unexpected things come up. We just want you to know we appreciate you, and we feel very confident and excited about serving you in this new way. And we're going to do whatever it takes to get through this together. And we really appreciate the encouragement along the way, especially the team. They've been just pulling out all the stops to make people laugh, to care. And I'm very thankful for the team that we have right now. So I'll check out the questions. Not a lot of questions so far, but I will stay on a little bit. Appreciate that, Mike. Appreciate that, Viola. Yeah. Yes, 55 sessions a week. Yeah, it's that's why we need backup, just in case something happens. So I'll wait another minute or two, but it's great to see you folks. And again, I really appreciate you being here. And just want to encourage you to keep doing the best you can physically and mentally. We just have to keep moving, or else things are not going to be as good as they could be if we did it. Is the accountability program going to be my coach? So for the most part, yes. If you're absolutely against it, then we can do something else. The thing with my coach is they're developing new features all the time. So for example, if you were just to do a workout and you wanted to be accountable and let your coach know, they're going to have a workout button right in the software that you can press, and it'll notify your coach, as well as there'll be the ability to embed some of the workout content right in there. Does this mean that our current memberships all expire on October 31st? Close, good question. There'll be a change in the membership on the payment date in November, but it will depend. So some people will, it'll be on like the 2nd, some people will be on the 21st. It really just depends on when your specific date comes up. So you might have to check your statement to see when that is. And then at that point, someone will have either a new 12-month membership with 3 months current pricing, or it'll just finish off whatever the months are on their current membership, but with the new pricing. I love the cold air blowing on me this morning. Okay, great. So then the air is working. Good. Oh, thank you, Brent. Miss seeing you, man. Hopefully we can see you soon. So I'll stay a little longer just in case, because it seems like there's a few questions. But again, if you do have any more specific questions, we'd love to chat with you on the phone. And yeah, even right now, Jen's at the gym recording a workout because Jethro had to stay home because his wife had a sore throat and just being cautious. So, you know, that's why you hear the commotion with the kids. But luckily they didn't run in here and disrupt things. So if you have anything else, Viola, it will change in November unless you want to renew again for 12 months, and then it would change in February. Yes, Melanie. And those of you who ordered kettlebells, they should be in by the end of the month, finally. So I'll be very happy to pass those over to you as soon as we get them. Awesome. I'll stay on another minute. And yeah, it's great to be with you, even if it's just through the computer. Thanks, Kelly. Awesome. So again, tomorrow morning, there's 3 live sessions for mobility. There's some new neck stuff we're doing and hip stuff as well. So those are all in the gym. And online as well, live for those three times. So if you're feeling a little stiff or you need some stress relief that's a little easier on the body, please join us for those. All right. Have a great evening, everybody. Thanks for being here.